Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome back to another video. This is Ibra, but in this video I'm not talking anything, everything will be come from FM radio BBC. Okay, so I'm a very big fan of BBC, so in this video I will just share with you, if you every day will listen BBC FM radio, it's gonna be help for you. Let's listen together BBC FM radio.
Again next week, but until then, this is Max Pearson from all of us here. Thanks for listening. Goodbye. inside the Next World Book Club. It's the story of a lovely young woman who, desperately in need of work, submits to the sexual demands of the director of a perfume company. Her body gradually begins to change, growing more and more like the body of a pig. World Book Club with Lucky Dahlia Sig at bbcworldservice.com/worldbookclub. To the BBC World Service. Today we are making changes to our normal schedule. In light of events affecting the BBC's coverage of live Premier League football, we're unable to bring you Sports World. Next today, it's the real story. This is the BBC World Service, the world's radio station.
Service. This is Chris Morris with The Real Story. One topic, 1 hour, every week. And this week, a new Brexit deal for Northern Ireland. Can the Windsor framework help break the logjam following the UK's exit from the European Union? It's partly about ensuring that trade between Great Britain and Northern Ireland, both part of the UK, is as easy as possible, even though Northern Ireland remains in the EU single market for goods, subject to many of its rules. There are also issues of sovereignty and identity to consider. Unionists in Northern Ireland remain wary of anything that seems to separate them in any way from mainland Britain. And they're still boycotting Northern Ireland's devolved government as a result. Both the UK and the EU think this deal is a breakthrough. There are hopes that it can help reinvigorate other parts of the relationship. But can the Northern Ireland Brexit dilemma finally be resolved? That's all on The Real Story from the BBC, coming up after the news.
BBC News with Sue Montgomery. Central Mozambique is being lashed by intense rain and powerful winds from a tropical storm that has hit the country for the second time in a month. As a result of Cyclone Freddy, Mozambique has received more than a year's worth of rainfall in the past 4 weeks. People have been urged to move into temporary shelters. Guy Taylor is from the charity UNICEF.
Mozambique is a country that's facing many humanitarian challenges already. About 2 million people in the north in need of humanitarian assistance, combating a cholera outbreak, needing a large-scale polio vaccination campaign. And this is a country already facing widespread poverty.
Cyclone Freddy is thought to be the longest-lasting tropical storm ever recorded, having first formed in early February. The Italian Coast Guard says it's brought more than 1,000 migrants to safety at Italian ports after their boats ran into difficulties in the Mediterranean Sea. In total, 3 vessels were rescued from rough seas off southern Italy early on Saturday. Here's Steve Jackson.
3 separate vessels got into difficulty in rough seas off southern Italy. The small boats were overloaded, carrying several hundred people each. They've been taken to ports in Calabria and Sicily. Tackling migrant boat crossings is a priority of the far-right Prime Minister Giorgia Meloni. On Thursday, she announced tougher prison sentences for people traffickers. But government figures show that more than 17,000 people have arrived by sea in Italy so far this year, 3 times the total for the whole of 2022. The government is under pressure to stop the boats, but has also been accused of doing too little to save lives at sea.
Protests are taking place in cities across France against legislation that will raise the pension age by 2 years to 64. The reform was approved by the Senate on Thursday, when more than 1 million people took part in rallies. So far, the protests appear to have been peaceful. President Macron insists the change is necessary to guarantee future pensions. Talks are taking place in Geneva between Yemen's government and Iranian-backed Houthi rebels, aimed at securing an exchange of prisoners. The negotiations are being overseen by the United Nations and the International Committee of the Red Cross, as Electra Naismith explains.
It's hoped these talks will see both sides fulfill obligations to release all detainees held in relation to the conflict. The UN Special Envoy spoke of the thousands of Yemeni families who'd waited far too long to be reunited with their loved ones. Yemen is entering its 9th year of civil war. It's seen hundreds of thousands of lives lost and millions displaced. But there is hope. On Friday, Iran and Saudi Arabia agreed to restore diplomatic relations after years supporting opposing sides in Yemen. Analysts suggest that easing of hostility could bring a solution to the conflict closer.
BBC News. Angola says it will send a military unit to the east of the Democratic
Democratic Republic of Congo, days after a ceasefire it brokered failed to end fighting between rebels and government troops. A statement from the Angolan president's office said the soldiers would secure areas where rebels from the M23 group were stationed. A ceasefire was supposed to have begun on Tuesday, but fighting was still happening on Friday. More than 9,000 residents of California are under evacuation orders as a large swathe of the U.S. state is again battered by torrential rain and strong winds. Flooding has blocked parts of several major highways in the San Francisco Bay Area and cut off neighborhoods in the town of Soquel. More than 54,000 people were without power on Friday. BBC has apologized to sports fans after scrapping large parts of today's coverage in a deepening dispute about impartiality. The corporation took its best-paid star, Gary Lineker, off air on Friday over tweets he posted criticizing the British government's use of language on immigration. A range of other BBC sports broadcasters and pundits then pulled out of programs in solidarity. Greg Dyke is a former BBC Director General.
It seems to me that the pattern in the BBC is that news and current affairs employees are expected to be impartial and not the rest. In this case, Gary Lineker is a much-loved football presenter. And if you start applying the rules of news and current affairs to everybody who works for the BBC, where does it end?
The American skier Michaela Schifrin has become the most successful racer in the history of World Cup skiing with her 87th win. She won the women's slalom at Åre in Sweden, surpassing a record set by Ingemar Stenmark in 1989. BBC News.
This is the real story from the BBC. I'm Chris Morris with your weekly deep.
So thank you so much for hearing BBC FM radio. See you another day with another BBC FM radio. Till then, you'll be cool. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz and Assalamu Alaikum.